Hello YouTube, it is 10:52 p.m. Just got off shift, my first night shift working for MLS, and I can't believe just how absolutely chill and fun that was. Yeah, the new guy that got me training is just totally cool as fuck, and it was steady. In fact, we managed to stay busy pretty much the entire night. I think there were two more vehicles we could have moved by the time our shift was over at 10:30. So I'm at 24th Street Station at the Phoenix SkyTrain. This is kind of neat. Over here on the west side of it, there's an outside portion and the ceiling goes up. And I'm not quite sure what the purpose of those elevators and that deck up there is, other than cool scenery, I guess. I don't see that it serves any purpose, but I like it. And I like this, it's open air. It's still 100 degrees, but you know, after as hot and sunny as it's been, 100 degrees right now just actually feels pretty good. So the elevator's over here, and yeah, I got a little hang time right as I came up the escalators. So at the ground floor, all the doors on the west side, which is directly adjacent to 24th Street, are locked up. So I have to walk all the way across to the east side to get into the escalators to get up into the station. I haven't seen any security here, which is kind of comforting, as I was still kind of put off by the fact that I got stopped and asked to see my ID. I'm like, really, dude? Like, I'm wearing an MLS safety vest and a reflective hat, and I'm kind of running late for work already. Come on now. A little disappointed myself, though, that I forgot to bring my ID. I don't really like the lanyard that they gave me at all. I'm gonna see if I can find my retractable lanyard that I got from Amazon, because I like that one a whole lot better. It's a pretty cool view here. Looking out, of course, trying to shoot video of it, I get as much reflection on the glass of the stuff behind me as I do all the open lights out before me, but yeah, I had to walk across. And in case you're curious why the hell I'm getting on the train at 24th Street Station, I think I forgot to mention, oh, here comes the train right now, I can hear it. All right, I need to get over there and get on this train. This is the train home for me. So this may be the first time ever I've gotten a SkyTrain car. And I'm alone. I'm all alone. It's empty. I mean, the doors are open. It's going to be here for a moment. But I don't see anybody getting on here. 24th Street Station.
Please stay clear of the doors.
I mean, to be fair, it wasn't completely empty. Now, right when I came up the escalators, another guy came up right behind me. And right as I came up, the train was taking off. But the frequency of this is great.
Please, like, hold on.
You missed the train.
This train is bound for Terminal 3 and Terminal 4.
You missed the train, and the next one's along in just a couple of minutes, which is really how public transit should work. It just doesn't really work like that in Phoenix
next
anywhere.
Stop, Terminal 3.
Other than right here on the SkyTrain. And I guess
welcome to America's friendliest airport.
There is a section of... there is a section of Thomas Road where the 29 runs pretty darn frequently, but yeah, like right after I came up the escalator, another guy came up behind me and was like, yeah, we just missed it. He's like, it's all good. Next one will be along in about 4 minutes. I'm like, yep, love this. That's the best public transit ride in town. Tunnel's a trip looking backwards. It still trips me out how it's a tunnel on one side and it's just open on the other side. Really curious what that's about. I think those are all private planes out there where the red lights are. So pretty trippy working the night shifts. One thing I found out tonight is that Hertz and the rental car center literally stay open all 24 hours. That I did not know. Now, there becomes less and less people working and less departments opening or opened as the night progresses. And it was pretty trippy. I mean, because at this point, the nighttime maintenance driver crew is me and the new guy. That's it. Now, I have been told that once summer is over, come September, October, when it starts to get busy again and people start coming to Phoenix to get away from the cold and other places, that it will get crazy busy. It will get crazy busy, and then we'll get... We'll have more people working, but for now it's just me and the new guy whose name I absolutely forget. So in case you're curious why I was getting on at 24th Street Station, Terminal 3 Station. I expect there's probably going to be somebody getting to join me here at this stop. Oh yeah. Well, good news and bad news. The bad news is Valley Metro fucked me again. And I'll explain that in a moment. That's the bad news. The good news is Waymo showed up like instantly, and I actually got the app to work in my iPhone, which is always kind of a dicey thing. It says I'll be home in 8 minutes. And robot driving. Still trips me out looking over the driver's seat and just seeing that wheel handling itself, but I've rode in enough of these, like I'm completely comfortable. In fact, I have more faith in the Waymo driver than pretty much any Lyft or Uber driver at this point. Because the Waymo driver seems to understand how to use a roundabout, which is more than could be said of the average Phoenix human driver. So I ended that last video because there were a couple of people stepping on that SkyTrain car that I had to myself. Just two people got on, rode from Terminal 3 to Terminal 4 and got off. And at Terminal 4, that train car got full. And it was all people working it. All people, you know, in work outfits and with Sky Harbor employee badges. So, you know, I should play some music. What we got? Hits now, EDM, hip-hop. It's always dicey with the hip-hop R&B. Like, am I playing something I like, or am I playing something that's just bleh? Oh, rock or alternative. See, those are just, same thing. It could be stuff that I really like, or it could just be bleh. I think I'll take my shot at alternative. Starting stream. Nosebleeds, Mr. Wise. I have no idea what that is. I was hoping for something better than that. Yeah, cruising up 44th Street. So there were no limes anywhere near here. The closest spin was somewhere like behind the Burger King here in that parking lot. Oh, you almost made it, Waymo. You almost had it. Wow, what the hell kind of gaudy SUV is that? And headlight beam is just obnoxious. So yeah, a whole bunch of people got on at Terminal 4, and at that point I thought I'd better check the Valley Metro app just to make sure I'd have a bus to get home, because I'm not sure how late the Route 44 runs these days. It's been a while since I've used it at night. And I'm looking at like, whoa, the last bus leaves soon, and I'm concerned I'm not going to make it in time. I think the last bus is scheduled at like 11:15. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm going to make it. And I see it there on the GPS, like it had just pulled up. Like I clicked on the bus on a GPS, and it showed that it was the one coming southbound from Desert Ridge. And it was sitting there. And this is like at about 11:04, 11:03-ish, as I'm leaving Terminal 4. And I'm thinking, yeah,
We're definitely making it to 44th Street Station within 10 minutes. Not a problem. And the bus is there. So I'm expecting once I come down the escalator, which is why I didn't bother to shoot a video. Not trying to lollygag a shooting a vlog video and miss my damn bus, because it's the last bus of the night. And I'm walking down, like kind of, I first went out the train, and I'm quickly going down the escalator and down the other escalator, and I walk right out, and I'm expecting to see the bus right there outside the door. And there's no bus there, and I'm thinking, well, that's weird. It just showed it was there in the GPS. It's not like that bus, ooh, we got party lights up ahead, going the wrong direction on the road. I don't think Waymo was reacting to that. I think Waymo's just slowing down because we're coming up on a red light. So anyway, the robot offers no explanation for slowing down. So I'm thinking it's really weird because it's not like, the bus that came southbound should be the bus that takes off northbound. That's how that bus works. It's usually pretty simple. It comes there, typically the driver gets out of the bus and takes a pee break inside the SkyTrain station or sits there in the seats outside and has a smoke break. Usually they're cool and will let me get on the bus to get in the air conditioning even if they're not done with their smoke break. And then they, when it's time to leave, they leave. We go northbound and it's a pretty quick drive from SkyTrain station up to Oak Street, and I walk home. A little bit less than a half mile down Oak. It's a pleasant walk. I mean, it's about 100 degrees outside right now, but hey, that's a cool Phoenix summer night. Yeah, I've been hearing this song on the radio. Let's see who the artist is. Pierce the Veil, Emergency Contact. Contact, yeah. Playing from iHeartRadio. God, they're just taking over everything, aren't they? Usually, I've been hearing that song. It's okay. I don't think it's great, but it's okay. It's catchy. Yeah, it feels like the Waymo driver's got a little more aggressive since the last time I rode it. Like, it used to go a lot slower approaching the red lights. Now it's getting right up on it. Not sure why. It's accelerating a little faster. Yeah, we're up to 40 miles per hour for the first block here. I'm not looking at the app, so I don't know if it's planning on taking Oak or if it's planning on taking Palm. Probably taking Oak. No reason for it to take me to my back door. So I'm surprised the bus is not there. I checked the app, and I see this shit. It should straight up be illegal to cancel the last bus. I mean, it's one thing if you're going to cancel a bus because you don't have a driver, but they had a driver. That bus was there. I saw it on the GPS. It was there. I don't understand when the driver's just like, oh, no, I don't want to work anymore today. I know. Oh, yeah, can't forget my sandwich. Thank you, robot. So, I don't understand it. I've never seen that happen before. Generally speaking, if a bus is canceled, it's because there's not a driver to drive it and it's not coming, you know. But I saw it arrive and it was there in the app when I was between Terminal 4 and East Economy parking. So my mind is blown that it left. And for it to leave when it's the last bus, the next bus isn't until after 4 in the morning. There were two other guys I could tell worked there, and one guy, I think he called his wife and said, I'm sorry, honey, I'm not going to be home until after 5. And explained what happened. And at which point I looked at the two scooter apps and saw one had, Lime had nothing near me. Spin was farther than I felt like going, and I was like, you know what, let's see if I can get the Waymo app to work with my wonky iPhone screen, and I did. So, robot dropping me off.
You're here. Please make sure it's clear before exiting.
We good. Thank you, robot.
I love these things. That, granted, that's $10 I probably shouldn't have spent, but I've had a long crazy day. I'm just ready to be in my bed. So yeah, we'd love your feedback. Tell us about your trip. Just got a push through from Waymo. I'd say on a scale of 1 to 10, that Waymo trip was a 10. I mean, it was like instant, like from the point that I clicked it, and it didn't show its approach, but as I was getting in it, there was a guy that was like, hey, I just got out of that. Those things are a trip. I'm like, yeah, I use them all the time. I said I was going to take the bus home, but they canceled at the last second. Bastards. Thank God for robot cars.